ओम नमो ब्रह्मादिभ्यो ब्रह्म विद्या संप्रदाय कर्तृभ्यो शर्षिभ्यो महद्भ्यो नमो गुरुभ्यः सर्वोपप्लवरहितः प्रज्ञानघनः प्रत्यगर्तु ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि। नारायणं पद्मभूम वशिष्ठं शक्तिं च तत्पुत्र पराशरं च व्यासं शुकं गौड़पदं महांतं गोविंद योगेन्द्र मथास्य शिष्यं श्री शंकराचार्य मथास्य पद आदम च अमलकंच शिष्यं तंतोटकं वार्तिककारमन्यानस्मद्गुरुं संततमानतोऽस्मि। श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। सॉरी। यद्ब्रह्मगोचर विचित्रतमः प्रभावात् संसारदीयनितदुःखमर्जनस्य यद्ब्रह्मदीजनितसौख्यमभूच्च तस्य तं रुक्मिणीसहितकृष्णमहं नमामि। यमिह कारुणिकं शरणं गतोऽप्यरि सहोदरापमहत्पदं तमहमाशु हरिं परमाश्रये जनकजाङ्कमनन्तसुखाकृतिम्। सो वी वेर लुकिंग एट दि प्रमाणस being pratyaksha, anumana and arthapatti to establish adhyasa by establishing that pramanas rest upon an avidyavan pramata. Then how can it be called as pramana? It can still be called as pramana, said the Siddhanti, refuting the objection that pramata can have karana dosha only when he becomes a pramana, whereas the avidya itself cannot be shown to be a dosha because pramata will not be a pramata unless avidya is accepted. Therefore, it is not a flaw at all, and the manas, karanas in the pramata, acting in the pramata, can still be called as pramana. Further, if there are other karanas which have doshas, then they will not be pramanas. So thereby, that second objection, which was other than the first prashna, that also stands answered or refuted. Not here. कथम पुनः यतमेतम य। सो हियर नाउ द आंसर टू अनदर क्वेश्चन, व्हाट इज द आक्षेप मेड नाउ? द आक्षेप इज दिस व्याप्ति डज नॉट वर्क। यत्र यत्र व्यवहारः तत्र तत्र अध्यासः। अध्यास पूर्वक व्यवहार, दिस इज नॉट एक्सेप्टेबल टू द सिद्धांति, टू द पूर्व पक्षी, एंड ही सेज इट शुड नॉट बी एक्सेप्टेबल टू द सिद्धांति ऑल्सो। वाई सो? ही सेज देयर इज व्यभिचार। सो द क्वेश्चन रेज इन द एंड, वी सॉ देयर वाज अ क्वेश्चन रेज एज टू ननु यदुक्तम अन्वय व्यतिरेकाभ्याम व्यवहारः अध्यास कार्यः इति तदयुक्तम। इट इज इललॉजिकल। व्हाई? बिकॉज दिस व्याप्ति डज नॉट वर्क। यत्र यत्र व्यवहार तत्र तत्र अध्यास अन्वयः। सो अध्यास, यत्र अध्यासो नास्ति तत्र व्यवहारोपि नास्ति। सो दिस व्याप्ति वेर अन्वय व्यतिरेक इज सीन, को प्रेजेंस एंड को एब्सेंस ऑफ अध्यास वेर एवर देर इज व्यवहार एंड वेर एवर देर इज नो व्यवहार, और रादर वेर एवर इन जागृत अवस्था देर इज व्यवहार अध्यास हैज बीन सीन, एंड वेर एवर देर इज नो व्यवहार दैट इज इन सुषुप्ति अवस्था देर अध्यास हैज नॉट बीन सीन। Why so? What is the Vyabhichara? Where do you see there not being Adhyasa and still there being Vyavahara? He says in the case of Jnani. In the case of Vidvas, Vidwan, Vidusham Adhyasa Bhavepi, Vyavahara Drishtehe Ichyata Aha Pashwadi Bhishcha Iti. In the case of Vidwan, Jnani, where avidya nasha has taken place, adhyasa is not there. So if adhyasa is not there, still vyavahara is there. No siddhanti will say that there adhyasa for a jnani as per the Purvapakshi. Purvapakshi's perspective is that you, the siddhanti, says that jnani has no adhyasa, then adhyasa bhava is there, adhyasa abhava is there. There being adhyasa abhava, still vyavahara is seen, because jnani also, if nothing, he goes for bhikshatana. But then we see so many other vyavaharas also, not only bhikshatana. Does the jnani teach? If nothing, you will say Shankaracharya jnani taught. Then did he have adhyasa? Because vyavahara was there. Acharana shows vyavahara, thereby adhyasa not being there, vyavahara being possible, there is Vaikalya, there is Vyabhichara. Ityata aha pashvadi bhischa iti. Therefore, Bhagavan Bhashyakara says, Jnani that you talk about, Vidwan, in their case what happens? Tasmad, avidyavad vishyani va pratyakshadini pramanani shastrani cha. And if you point out, no, there is vyabhichara in this case, because jnani does not have adhyasa but still has vyavahara, there he says pashvadi vishcha avisheshat. Even the jnani that you are talking about, there is avishesha. Every prani, pashu, during vyavahara kala has adhyasa, you have to accept it. Similarly, in the case of Vidwan also, Pashwadi Vishcha Avishesha, there is no difference between anyone who is having Vyavahara during the Vyavahara Kala and any Pashu also, Pashu Pakshi having Vyavahara. There is no difference. That's a big statement. Generally, it will be taken as an insult, but it is not so. Why? He explains. यथा ही पश्वादयः शब्दादिभिः श्रोत्रादीनां संबंधे सति शब्दादिविज्ञाने प्रतिकूले जाते ततो निवर्तन्ते अनुकूले च प्रवर्तन्ते यथा दण्डोद्यतकरं पुरुषम् अभिमुखम् उपलभ्य माम हन्तुमयमिच्छति इति पलायितुमारभन्ते हरिततृणपूर्ण पाणिम् उपलभ्य तं प्रति अभिमुखी भवन्ति एवं पुरुषा अपि. So he gives an example of a prani and extends it to yutpanna chittaha vidushamapi. Yutpanna chittanam vidushamapi vyavaharaha samanam eva. So samana vyavahara, he shows that vyavahara is same. What is the similarity there? He says you take a cow, for example, any pashu. So he says yathahi pashvadayaha, Pashu Pakshi and Ajnani, human beings also, Shabdadivi Shrotradinam Sambandhisati, when the Pramanas, what is being shown here? Pramanas are resting upon Avidyavad Vishaya. So in the case of Pranis also it is so. So it is, the answer is twofold. Although the question is raised, he says it is not only true about human beings or jnanis, it is true in the case of Pashu Pakshis also. The Pramanas resting upon Avidyavad Vishaya. So, when a Pashu Pakshi hears some Shabda through the Shrotradi Indriyas, which are Pramanas. So, Shrotradinam Shabdadivihi Sambandhe Sati, when there is a Sambandha of the Pramana with the Prameya, then Prama takes place. There is absolutely no choice. If the mind is backing the indriyas, when the indriya goes out and connects with a prameya vishaya, then the pramana prameya sambandha will give rise to prama. Shabdadi vijnane pratikule jate. Once this prama takes place, there is buddhi. In each and every prani, Bhagavan Ishvara has given buddhi. Paramatma has given buddhi to understand whether this is favorable to me or not favorable to me. Do I like this or do I not like this? Is it ishta or anishta? Ishta sadhana or anishta sadhana? Will this lead to my happiness or will this lead to my sorrow? This is the bare minimum prajna that is there in each and every sentient being. I mean, this is utsarga, generally so. So thereby, shabdadi vidyane pratikule jate. Once the prajna that takes place, prama that takes place in the antakarana of the pashu as to this shabda, this rasa, this sparsha ityadi is something that I like. Pratikule jate. If it is favorable, then anukule jate. Anukule is later. So pratikule jate, if it is not favorable, if it is anishta sadhana, if it leads to dukkha, then what? Tato nivartante. They go away from there. They do not want this shabda to be heard. They do not want this kind of a sparsha. They do not want to taste something which has been offered, which is pratikula, which is not anukula at all, which is not favorable at all, unfavorable, because it leads to sorrow. Anukule cha pravartante. If it is anukula, if it is favorable, it feeds the like and thereby leads to happiness, then pravartante, they are drawn towards it. So you feed a bird, the bird knows that this is something that is going to fill my stomach, it is going to take away my hunger, or I like this, whatever it is tasty, and then the birds flock there. As soon as you scare them away, or they see even a person walking by fast nearby, the bird would fly away even when it is eating. Therefore, this is common knowledge, there is nothing to be discussed here. Now, a specific example, you take a cow. So, yatha dandodhyatakaram purusham abhimukham upalabhya. Looking at a person who is having a danda in his hand, he has a stick in his hand, then the cow knows that this is not a good scenario to be in because this is pratikula for me. This fellow is going to hurt me. So, mam hantumayam ichyati, he is going to hurt me. It may not, the cow may not know that it has ventured into cow or a bull or whatever, you know. Generally, we don't want to hurt a cow. But then, what happens if you go to village sites, they have grown their fields with lot of effort. And if a cow wanders there and starts eating up everything that is going to lead to their own livelihood, then they have no other choice but to scare it away with a danda. Maybe tap it a little or just, you know, hammer it on the ground and then the cow will run away. Why? Because mam hantu vayam ichyati iti palayitum aravante. They begin to take a run because they know that this fellow is going to hurt me. Whereas if you hold green grass, harita truna purna panimupalabhya, however, seeing a person who has green, fresh green grass in his hands, tam prati abhimukhi bhavanti. Wherever they are, just a glance is sufficient, they'll come running to you. So the cow comes running to you. Evam purushapi. Similarly, is the case of human beings. In this case, there is no difference in vyavahara as to feeding the likes and discarding what we dislike. There is no difference between a human being and a prani. Evam purusha api yutpanna chitta, and what not an ajnani alone, viveki also. Yutpanna chittas are vivekis. Those who know the difference between right and wrong, even those, because of vasanas, likes and dislikes are still there. स्वयं पुरुषापि व्युत्पन्न चित्ताः क्रूर दृष्टीन आक्रोशतः खड्गोद्यत करान बलवतः उपलभ्य ततो निवर्तन्ते. लुकिंग एट अ पर्सन, जस्ट बिकॉज वन इज अ ज्ञानी एंड देयर सम थीव्स हैव कम इन, वन विल हैव अ संस्कार दैट आई डोंट वांट टू टेक अ बीटिंग. These guys can beat me, they can hurt me. I can empty the place right now. I can take a run, walk away from there or run away. So, tato nivartante. Looking at whom? Looking at krura drishti. Akroshata khadgodyata karan balavataha upalabhya. Those who, by looking at them, you know, you see krura. Cruelty is spilling of their eyes also. You look at some people, you know, eyes are red and then anger is there. They just want to hurt whatever is around. They'll just start throwing things. So we see such things if nowhere else, you know, we've seen it in movies. And we can infer also if you have not come across such people. But still, having seen such people, what do those who have an understanding? Vyutpanna chitta. Purushapi vyutpanna chitta. What do? They run away. And here the example is, you know, even somebody is carrying a weapon, etc. Khadgodhyata karan. Carrying a. Those who are carrying weapons in their hands. So having looked at them, Purusha tato nivartante. So anishta sadhana is there. Tad viparitan prati pravartante. Whereas those who are opposed to such people, who are not krura, very friendly, very helpful, towards them, there is a friendly approach as well. So human beings approach them. Ataha, therefore, samanaha pashvadibhi purushanam pramana prameya vyavaharaha. So the vyavahara between pashus and human beings, purushas, it is same. What kind of vyavahara? Pramana prameya vyavahara. This pramana, connecting, having sambandha with this prameya, its own prameya vishaya, will give rise to prama. That prama leads to an understanding which is weighed as to whether it is anukula or pratikula. If it is anukula, then there is pravrutti. If it is pratikula, there is nivrutti. There is no difference in that aspect. So let's look at, we'll come back here and we'll look at Vyakhyana now on this. So what is the intention when Bhagavan Bhashyakara talks about Pashus and then extends that to Vyutpanna Chitta Purushas also? So here Pashwadi Bhischa iti in Vyakhyana Cha Shabdaha Shankha Nirasartha Di Pashwadi Bhischa Avisheshat. Cha Shabda shows that there is no doubt here. This is clearly known as to Pashus also have this kind of an adhyasa. Adhyasa is to be accepted looking at the vyavahara. I am an individual, the other individual is going to hurt me. This kind of a basic understanding has to be accepted in Pashus also, which shows there is adhyasa. Now this is before the question, as in before answering the question as to adhyasa and vyavahara, that vyapti, that anvaya vyatireka that has been shown is objected to. Before that objection is answered, the vyapti is shown to extend to Pashus also, meaning it is applicable to Pashus, and then you bring back to Jnanis to answer the question. So, cha shabda shanka nirasa artha, there is no doubt regarding this behavior of pranis, Pashu. Kim vidvattvam, now having shown that, what is this objection about? As to vidushamapi vyavahara drishtehe, when you say vidusha, vidwan, vidwan also, the vidvas is the pratipadika sakaranta, so vidvas, all the vidwans also have vyavahara but they do not have adhyasa, then who do you mean by vidwan? First let me understand that and then answer it. So what is the question about who is the vidwan in your perspective? So kim vidvatvam brahma asmi iti sakshatkaraha uta yauktikam atmanatma bheda jnanam. So Siddhanti gives two options. Do you mean by vidwan as one who has sakshatkara of brahma asmi, aham brahma asmi, this sakshatkara is there, or do you mean to say someone who knows the difference between atma and anatma? Uta yauktikam atmanatma bheda jnanam. So one who knows that this is atma, I am atma, and this is anatma, meaning sentient and insentient difference one can make out. In the case of prani really, but in the case of dvaitins for example, or even an advaitin who has paroksha jnana as to atma, brahmatma is different from sharira. So yauktikam, using yukti, shastra gives some yukti or acharyas give some yukti and thereby one understands, oh, I am a sentient being, the body has sentience which is not its own, the body is going to die, I am going to survive. This much jnana is there, that person is also a vidwan because he has this vidya, atma vidya he has. He does not have advaita atma vidya, he has atma vidya. So adye, in the earlier case, when vidvattvam is that kind of vidvattvam in a vidwan who knows brahma asmi. Adye badhita adhyasa anurtya vyavahara iti samanvaya sutre vakshate. So this will be talked about in the fourth sutra, Samanvaya Sutra, Tattu Samanvayat. So there what will be shown? It will be shown that even jnani has vyavahara. How is this vyavahara possible? Because adhyasa is not there. Why is adhyasa not there? Adhyasa is avidya karya. Avidya is karana. Karana is gone away because vidya has come up. Vidya is avidya virodhini because avidya was vidya virodhini. So vidya becoming stronger, avidya has to go away, and avidya nasha taking place, avidya karya cannot survive. Karana nashe sati karyasya api nashaha. Then adhyasa is gone. If adhyasa is gone, how can you have adhyasa karya vyavahara? Because you have shown anvaya vyatireka. Adhyasa going away, vyavahara should go away. But vyavahara is seen. Then vyabhichara is there. In that case, the answer is badhita adhyasa anurtya. The anurtya of adhyasa is there. Adhyasa is still there. What kind of adhyasa is there? It is badhita. Just like a traveler in a desert sees water which is mirage water. He does not know. He runs towards it. Whereas the other traveler, he knows that it is mirage water. This person has never seen, Devadatta has never seen, who is new to the desert. He runs and jumps into that mirage water, but then finds out that it is only desert sand. Then Yajnadatta explains that this is mirage, this is how it works, refraction, etc. And then this person knows now. Just because he knows that due to refraction there can be a vision of mirage water, doesn't mean that he is not going to have a vision of mirage water. Yajnadatta sees that there is mirage water but does not take it as real. This is called as badhita anuvritti. The reality has been taken away, it has been negated. When you pull back the reality that has been lent to the prapancha, And prapancha is what? Adhyastha. So adhyasa does not have its reality. It is not real. Mithya bhavitum arhati. So that mithya bhavitum arhati, now you know this mithya means nasti iti. It cannot be really existent. So it, you give it some value because there is appearance, but then you don't take it to be real. That is badhita adhyasa, and that badhita adhyasa, negated, sublated adhyasa, continues to be there. Based on that, there is vyavahara. Iti samanvaya sutre vakshate. Dvitiye paksha, in the second paksha, kim nama vidvatvam. So if the purva paksha says, yauktikam atmanatma bheda jnanam. Knowing atma and anatma as different from each other, thereby there is yukti siddha jnana, that makes a person a vidwan. That kind of a vidwan also has vyavahara, but has no adhyasa. If you say so, dvitiye paroksha jnanasya aparoksha bhranti anivartakatvat. Vivekinamapi vyavahara kale pashvadibhir avisheshat adhyasavatvena tulyatvat vyavaharo adhyasakarya iti yuktam ityartha. If you say ayuktam, no, it is not ayukta, it is yukta. It is very much tenable, very much logical. Why so? Because what you are talking about is atma anatma bheda jnana. Being there in this jnani, this vidwan, which is yauktika, yukti siddha, but still it is paroksha. There is no sakshatkara, there is no clear understanding. Aparoksha jnana isn't there as to I am this Brahma and everything else is mithya, insentient. It is only by yukti, not by sakshatkara, anubhuti, anubhava. Aparoksha jnana, all have same meaning. Sakshatkara, anubhuti, anubhavaha, aparoksha jnanam, all have same meaning. Paroksha jnana is yukti siddha, based on what shastra says, what acharya says. You accept because you have shraddha there, you use some logic, but then you are not convinced without a doubt. Without a doubt in the sense, how can I be still lingering on? Viparita bhavana is still lingering on, if nothing else. I am still this individual, this person. This thought comes up again and again. It takes you back. Therefore, what? Dvitiye paroksha jnanasya. This jnana is paroksha jnana. Atma anatma bheda jnana is paroksha to that person, because it is yukti siddha. Therefore, it will remain. It is not from shravana that jnana has taken place completely. Some example is used. Through that example, logically, you will conclude that atma is different from anatma, like nayayikas. Nayayikas know that atma is different from anatma. Still, they'll go and analyze all the anatmas as well as atma as padarthas. They'll group atma and anatma into single set of padarthas, then bifurcate all of them. Atma is also a padartha. Atma is jnana adhishthana, not jnana rupa. Jnana adhishthana. So chaitanya adhishthana. Finally, adhishthana, and then they'll still think that everything else, every other padartha is different from atma, because atma alone is jnana adhishthana. They'll analyze everything else. So bheda is there. Not only do they know bheda between atma and anatma, they know atma, anatma, anatma bheda also. They have categorized anatma also into several, dravya, guna, ityadi, and then they know those differences also. But all this is what? Yauktika, yukti siddha. There is no leading to moksha there. Why? Because aikya jnana between Brahma and atma isn't there. Jnana adhishthanatvam is known, but the chaitanyatvam, chit swarupam, is not known really. Therefore, it remains as paroksha jnana. And paroksha jnana cannot take away अपरोक्ष अज्ञान, अज्ञान इज अपरोक्ष, अज्ञान इज नॉट परोक्ष. Somebody saying that, oh, you do not know Brahma, and you start thinking, oh, maybe he is right. That is not the case. What is the case? The case is Anubhava Siddha, that has been shown, Pratyaksha Siddha. Even if you inquire by Anumana and by Arthapatti, it is Pratyaksha Siddha. You may need the others to convince others, other Pramanas. But yourself, you know that aham manushya. So if you ask others, do you think that you are a manushya? As long as this idea is there, anubhava siddha, pratyaksha siddha, ajnana. Just because one knows oneself as manushya, it is very clear that one does not know that I am Brahma. Knowing oneself as manushya and Brahma, these are opposite. They are contrary to each other. I know myself as manushya in vyavahara, and I know myself as swarupatah Brahma is okay, because they are at different levels of reality. Satta is different. But in the same satta, so to say, who am I inquiry, you know? Ko aham? Then the answer comes, aham manushya ityadi. To answer others, it's okay because it is in a plane of vyavahara. But when I inquire into my real swarupa, then I should know that Brahma asmi. Satchidananda rupa Brahma asmi, and nothing additional should be there. Everything else is noise. It is not my swarupa at all. It is all incidental. Because I have prarabdha pending, I have been pushed into this kind of an anubhava, which is like a swapna anubhava. This Jagrat Anubhava is no different from Swapna Anubhava. That is a conviction. And then finally leading to Shunyatva of Prapancha. Tuchyatva of Prapancha. That is the gradation in the Jnani. The Utkrishta Jnani will not have Swapna Anubhava of Jagrat Avastha also. He may get absorbed in Samadhi also, or remain absorbed even while being in the Prapancha. Has nothing to do with the Karanas and Sharira. Things are getting done. So, Unmatta Pishachavat. So, there is some comparison given in some shloka. So, Unmatta Pishachavat appears like a madman. Nobody knows that he is a jnani. That is also possible at one extreme. Vyavahara may or may not be there because one may be absorbed in samadhi through and the body drops off. The prapancha may not even know that there was such a jnani. Because he did not share the jnana, there was no prarabdha of sharing the jnana. That case is also there. Thereby, aparoksha jnana alone can take away aparoksha ajnana. Ajnana is aparoksha here. Therefore, paroksha jnana of this dvitiya case, paroksha jnanasya dvitiya, paroksha jnanasya aparoksha bhranti anivartakatvat. There is no possibility of paroksha jnana taking away aparoksha bhranti. This bhranti, aham manushya, is a bhranti which is adhyasa, adhyastha in atma. Not knowing oneself as atma, this adhyasa is continuing. Although there is atma anatma bheda jnana, which is paroksha, it cannot take away this bhranti. Pratyaksha siddha bhranti continues to be there, aham manushya. Thereby, Vivekinamapi vyavahara kale pashvadibhir avisheshat. Specifically, vyavahara kale has been mentioned. Let's say this person has some understanding of aham brahma, but what happens is that there is a lot of baggage. Sadhana chatushte sampatti was not complete. Was not in a great measure. It was there, barely sufficient, somehow made it to the Vedanta party by gate crashing. Somehow due to Purva Samskara came there and then heard some Upanishad Pravachana or something, some Prakarana Grantha, and then thought that yes, this is something which makes sense. There are so many people, you know, you see on mailing lists and you know in discussion groups and whatnot, Facebook pages and WhatsApp groups, You see, a lot of people get together saying that there is a taste for Advaita. People who have absolutely no connection with Hindu culture also, Sanatana Dharma, they also have interest in Advaita because it seems right, makes some sense. There is some Purva Samskara. As Bhagavan Krishna says, Kalyanakrit. Nahi, Kalyanakrit kaschit Durgatim Tata Gacchati. He Tata, O Arjuna, anybody who is Kalyanakrit, who has some Purva Vasana of Jnana, Atma Jnana, will never lead to Durgati. Will always have a Sadgati, will get another Janma in a good family, a better birth than others have, and thereby what will happen? The journey will continue. There will be an incidental trigger that will continue the journey. He'll follow on from where he left off in the earlier Janma. So this is a case for many. But what happens is that there is no nishtha possible. Unless one gives up what has been told by the Shastras as not to pursue other than moksha and moksha sadhana. Moksha means jnana and jnana sadhana. If one continues other things in more measure, like earlier, then nishtha is not going to be possible. In fact, manana itself is not going to be possible. Manana takes a lot of time. Especially in today's era, it is very difficult to hold on to the understanding that you have. It is very easy to lose. There are so many occasions to be negligent and err. But then, lot of focus is needed, lot of patience is needed. So many things, we know all these aspects. So, thereby what happens is that the jnana remains paroksha. During vyavahara, it takes away. Why? Because manana siddha, jnana has not taken place. In vyavahara, one gets carried away. During vyavahara, this understanding that I am not a deha, I am not a manushya, I have no relation with anyone. Ahankara, mamakara itself is a bhranti. This is not there. Vyavahara takes the person completely. One gets immersed in that vyavahara. Thereby the ego is fed and more ragadveshas get manifest from the vasana and then they flourish into full-fledged samsara vriksha. Therefore what? Vivekinamapi. Even if there is an understanding of a great measure also, still vyavahara kale. During vyavahara what happens? Pashvadibhir avisheshat. One will go with the ragadvesha generally. Adhyasavatvena tulyatvat vyavaharo adhyasakaryeti yuktamityartha. This vyavahara which is adhyasakarya will continue because adhyasa bhranti which is aparoksha will not go away by paroksha jnana. Therefore during vyavahara, vyavahara is possible. During vyavahara meaning vyavahara is possible because adhyasa karya is vyavahara and adhyasa is continuing being aparoksha and not being dealt with by paroksha jnana. Adhyasa vatvena tulyatvat. Pashu also has adhyasa. Similarly in vyavahara kal this viveki also has adhyasa. Now, mind you, the earlier category, Prathama has been taken away. Adhya what? Badhita Adhyasa Anurti. That is different. When one is convinced so much that the Vyavahara is like Swapna Vyavahara, it is like a dreamer knowing that one is dreaming. So, if you have had that Anubhava, it is easier to relate. Meaning, easier to relate is you are convinced. You don't need an Acharya to tell you. You don't need someone else to tell you. You know, you have this Anubhava, which is clear. If not the Anubhava, you should know that it is a possible Anubhava. Imagine, if at all you have not had this Anubhava, imagine that you are dreaming, and in that dream, you know that you are dreaming. At least that is possible. So, the way we looked at in the Adhyasa Bhashya also, first Asambhava, then Sambhavana Bhashya, then Pramana. Pramana Bhashya. So in the Pramana Bhashya, we have landed because the Purva Pakshi has given into the Sambhavana. Now take this as a sambhavana. Is it possible that one can know that one is dreaming? Sometimes, you know, you pinch yourself. You know, there is a phrase in English, you pinch yourself to see whether this vyavaharika anubhava, is this real? So you go to some kind of a, you know, on a vacation, some kind of a picnic or a trip, and then you see such a beautiful place. You know, if you have gone higher up in the Himalayas in India, there may be other places outside India also. But you go to, you know, say Gaumukh or somewhere, Tapovan, you go to, where, you know, you don't see, it has not been damaged by the society yet. So you look at such kind of places, and then, you know, I remember this when we took a trip, an elderly person along with us in a group, senior citizen, he said that, oh, this is Swarga. And he was saying that there cannot be any other Swarga, this is Swarga. So there, what am I dreaming? How can I be alive and be in Swarga? That kind of a, you know, mind-boggling experience is there. It's a wonder. So we say, oh, Ashcharyavat Pashyati, the way Jnana is talked about in Kathopanishad and in Gita as well. So there you have an anubhava which makes you think whether I am really awake. I have never seen this in waking world. I see all sorts of filth, but I never see such a clean, beautiful place. Then you wonder, am I dreaming? And then they say, then you pinch yourself or something as a phrase, you know. Or you may end up pinching yourself also. Those who are, you know, have difficulty in seeing that whether I'm dreaming or I'm waking. Some people have these experiences as to, I'm not sure whether I'm dreaming right now. So you pinch yourself and try to wake yourself up. Now imagine this in a dream, that you are really dreaming, and then you have this samskara from waking as to, I can pinch myself. So you can pinch yourself, or you ask the other to pinch, and then you wake up. May or may not wake up, but imagine such a scenario that you are dreaming, and in the dream it is mind-boggling, and you wonder whether it is a dream. Whether you wake up from the pinch or not is a different story. But is there a possibility that you can know during the dream that you are a dreamer? Definitely possible. For some, anubhava siddha. Now in that case, that I am a dreamer. Let's say you do not think that I can pinch myself or someone can pinch me and I wake up. Or you assume that someone pinches also and you don't wake up. But you are convinced that it is a dream. So let's take the example that you don't think that I can pinch myself, but you start wondering whether it's a dream, and now you are slowly unable to make connections. What kind of connections? Oh, I don't remember my past history. I don't remember to which parents I was born. How did I come about in this? Let's say you are dreaming of a forest area. Oh, I don't remember having taken a trip. I don't remember having traveled at all, but I somehow landed here. Now, if you start inquiring into that background and you think that, oh, this has to be a dream, but I don't know a way to wake up, will you still interact? You will still interact because it is an anubhava. You feel cold in higher up Himalayas. You will see that if you have any way to protect yourself. So if you are protecting yourself, it is all bhajita anuvritti. You already know that you are dreaming. You are going along with the flow. There is a prarabdha to continue. This is the jnani's anubhava. So this is bhajita anuvritti. You know that you are dreaming. Unlike the person in the desert, who sees it, but he does not have to go along with it. He does not have to play along. He sees it, but then he has no value for that water because that water is unreal. But the dreamer has value for the water of the Ganga there itself. If he is thirsty, he can drink that water. There is a huge difference. There is utility. That utility which is there in the dream is there in Jagrat Avastha also for a jnani. A jnani has it is all known, but jnani also has vyavahara by bhajita anuvritti. He knows that there is utility. I have vyavaharika thirst. It will go only by vyavaharika Ganga adi nadi jala, and I can partake it. So the dream anubhava continuing, although knowing that you are dreaming, इज बाधित अनुवृत्ति सिमिलरली फॉर दि ज्ञानी बाधित अध्यास अनुवृत्ति व्यवहार हाउ इज व्यवहार पॉसिबल अध्यास इज देयर ओ बाधित अध्यास इज देयर बाधित अध्यास इज देयर इट हैज बीन लाइक दि स्नेक हूज फैंग्स हैव बीन टेकन अवे और भर्जित बीजवत शास्त्र गिव्स अनदर एग्जाम्पल भर्जित बीजवत दिस एंटायर व्यवहार हाउ डज दि ज्ञानी डू इट वॉट डज ही हैव टू गेन ही हैज नथिंग टू गेन So Gitacharya would say Loka Sangrahartham. As Bhagavan Krishna told Arjuna when he wanted to drop everything lock, stock and barrel. Anyone else without a perspective of Shastras or without a perspective of who is an Adhikari would say why is Krishna making him fight this war? Aghora. In fact, Arjuna has gone so far as to make an aropa on Bhagavan saying that what is that? Ghore tu karmani maam. So, ghore karmani maam. Kimartham niyojasi. I am paraphrasing. So, niyojasi. Maam niyojasi. Kutra ghore karmani. In this ghore karma of killing my own acharyas and bandhus. So, my own cousins, my own teachers, my own elders and relatives, you are making me kill. That is ghore karma. I am willing to give up while you are pushing me. Yudhyasva Bharata. So, what is this? From a onlooker's perspective, who is neutral to the Shastras, has absolutely no idea, no inkling, no idea of what Shastra's perspective is, who is an Adhikari. He says, oh, in this Krura Karma, Bhagavan Krishna is pushing Arjuna, whereas Arjuna had a way out. No, he did not. Karmani eva Adhikaraste. Ma phaleshu kadachana and further what? When Arjuna asks, which is better, you tell me. Across 3-4 chapters, which is better? Karma yoga or after knowing karma and jnana, which is better? You do prashansa of this also and that also. I am asking you, which is better? You say, look at karma yoga, this is a fact. Look at jnana yoga, this is a fact. Dvenishthe, you are talking about two commitments. Both leading to moksha, you tell me which is better. I am asking you a pointed question, give me a pointed answer. Bhagavan Krishna does not give. Finally, he says, in your case, karma yoga is better. Specifically, in your case, he says that. So, karmani eva adhikaraste. So, you go ahead with karma. Finally, he said, knowing all this, yadichasi tat kuru. However, Arjuna is not an adhikari there for jnana then. Why? Because karma yoga is not complete. He would be a gate crasher like one of us. Now, badhita adhyasa anuvritti, coming back to the topic, I don't recall why I took a detour there. So, badhita adhyasa anuvritya, Vyavahara is possible for a jnani. This will be discussed in detail in the Samanvaya Sutra, fourth Sutra, Tattu Samanvayat. And Dvitiye, we have seen that it is yukta, it is not ayukta. Atrayam prayoga. So what is meant here? Just by saying it, it is not going to establish anything. So Tarkika wants, what is the tarka used? You give me a vyapti linga. Paramarsha, something you give me. What is this? Just stating, look at these pashus, look at jnani, look at this badhita adhyasa. Atrayam prayogaha in the Nayayika's language, so that he understands that there is all this backing when I make a statement. Siddhanti makes a statement which is logical. Vivekinaha adhyasa vantaha vyavaharavatvat pashvadivat iti. This is the anumana. Vivekinaha adhyasavantaha, vivekina paksha, adhyasavanta is sadhya, vyavaharavattvam is hetuhu, pashvadivat is udharana. So what is the vyapti? Yatra yatra vyavahara tatra tatra adhyasa, which has already been discussed earlier. Yatha pashvadi. Therefore vivekinaha api. तत्र संग्रह वाक्यम व्याकुरुवन दृष्टांते हेतुं स्फुटयति. दि संग्रह वाक्य हैज बीन सेड एज पश्वादिविश्च अविशेषा. दि संग्रह वाक्य इज अ ब्रीफ स्टेटमेंट. देन भगवान भाष्यकार गोज ऑन टू एलाबोरेट व्याकुर्वन एक्सप्लेनिंग दि संग्रह वाक्य इटसेल्फ. हाउ इज पश्वादिविश्च अविशेष अविशेषात, हाउ इज दैट हेतु वर्किंग देयर. सो दृष्टांते हेतुं स्फुटयति क्लैरिफाइज दि पशु दृष्टांत हैज दिस हेतु. व्हाट इज हेतु? व्यवहारवत्वम. व्यवहार इज दि हेतु टू अंडरस्टैंड. अध्यास इज देर इन दि अर्लियर इन पूर्वकाल. अध्यास हैज टू बी एक्सेप्टेड यथा ही इत्यादि. सो वी हैव सीन दिस दैट एंटायर सेक्शन इज टॉकिंग अबाउट दि दि पशु हैविंग अध्यास बिकॉज ऑफ इष्ट अनिष्ट साधन. सो दैट इज डिस्कस हियर. विज्ञान से अनुकूलत्वम प्रतिकूलत्वम च इष्ट अनिष्ट साधन गोचरत्वम. व्हाट इज दिस अनुकूल एंड प्रतिकूल वर्ड हैज बीन यूज्ड. व्हाट इज फेवरेबल, व्हाट इज अनफेवरेबल. सो हियर फेवरेबल मीन्स इष्ट साधनत्वम एंड इट इज नोन टू दी गौ देयरफॉर इष्ट साधन गोचरत्वम. The cow knows that this is ishta sadhana. Pashu, general case, the pashu knows that this is ishta sadhana for me and therefore anukula and pratikula mean unfavorable. What is unfavorable? This is anishta sadhana. And since it knows anishta sadhana, gocharatvam, pratikulatvam. So ishta sadhana, so this samasa has to be read ishta sadhana, anishta sadhana. Ishta anishta is ishta sadhana gocharatvam cha anishta sadhana gocharatvam. इष्टानिष्ट साधन गोचरत्वम एंड दिस विल करेक्ट विथ इंडिविजुअली विथ व्हाट अनुकूलत्व एंड प्रतिकूलत्व. सो विज्ञानस्य अनुकूलत्वम दिस प्रमा दैट टेक्स प्लेस व्हेन प्रमाणा कम्स इन कॉन्टैक्ट संयोग विथ प्रमेय. प्रमा टेक्स प्लेस दैट इज विज्ञान इवन फॉर पशु. सो देर अनुकूलत्वम इज व्हाट इष्ट साधन गोचरत्वम एंड प्रतिकूलत्व इज अनिष्ट साधन गोचरत्वम. तदेव उदाहरति यथा इति एंड देन ही गिव्स स्पेसिफिक एग्जांपल एज टू the dandodyutakaram and haritatruna pani upalabhya. So ayam dandaha madanishta sadhanam. This is what the cow knows. This danda which the human being is carrying there, it is madanishta sadhanam. For me it is anishta. Anishta sadhana, it is means to something which is undesirable. I don't want to be beaten because it will bring a lot of hurt and sorrow. Therefore, it has anubhava. If not in this janma, earlier janma anubhava continues. Just like when a newborn child knows that suckling on the mother's breast is going to give milk, which is ishta sadhana, which is going to take away the hunger. The samskara is there. If you say a human child is trained, how is a calf trained? The calf which is newly born knows that it has to drink milk of its mother. That samskara is there. So purva janma is siddha there. Samskara is siddha there. Similarly, if a kid is taken towards something which is hurting, a fire or something which has more heat, which you can tolerate, but the child with a younger and a thin skin is not able to tolerate, so starts crying, knows that this is anishta. Similarly, Pashu also. Pashu cannot talk but knows. Therefore, ayam dandaha mad anishta sadhanam. It is not ishta. It is not leading to something desirable, happiness for me. Dandatvat. Anubhuta dandavat. So, this is the vyapti there. Knows that yatra yatra dandatvam tatra tatra mad anishta sadhanatvam. Yatha anubhuta danda. There is a danda anubhava. I was beaten earlier. So we'll take a simpler case of in this janma. It had seen danda. It was beaten earlier. So the prani knows that this danda is also going to bring me unhappiness. It is anishta sadhana. Idam trunam ishta sadhanam. Whereas the blade of grass or the bunch of grass that has been held, that is ishta sadhana. Why? Anubhuta jatiyatvat. So yatra yatra the same truna which has been given, what the person is offering, the grass that the person is offering, that itself has not been eaten earlier. So there is no anubhava that grass, that particular grass, there is no anubhava. Just like one, somebody says that oh, I have cough. So the friend suggests, oh, why don't you take this aushadha? He says that, oh, I have this, I'll give it to you. He brings out medicine and says, try this. You look at it, you have tried that medicine earlier. So you say, no, I have tried this, this hasn't worked. What does it mean by you have tried that? Have you tried? Then the person says, have you tried this? So I have tried this very. You have not tried that very medicine. Why? Because that medicine is a single unit of that it's a single piece, a bottle which has a particular medicine. That very medicine you haven't tried. You have tried something of the same jati, same brand, elsewhere in a different bottle. So the medicine is different. The same medicine means what? It is same jatiya medicine. It's the same brand. It is the same this also. I mean, it's not only a company, but the product is also same. But there is difference in units. Units are different. Definitely units are different. It is like saying that, I don't like apples. This apple, I have eaten this apple. Have you tried this particular green apple? You say, I have eaten green apple before. So I don't like this. I haven't eaten it. That very piece you haven't eaten. Therefore, the other end says, so why don't you try this? No. Anubhutiya jati is there. You have eaten something, some other unit of apple, you have seen some other piece of apple, but green apple again. Looks very similar, is the same, from the same area also maybe, but still you wouldn't like it. So there is anubhuta jatiyattvam, not the same. Samanattvam is what? Anubhuta jatiyattvam. So as long as this anubhutiya jatiya grass is offered, then that grass is ishta sadhana. That prani also knows. So idam trunam ishta sadhanam anubhute jatiyatvat anubhuta trunavat. Just like the earlier truna which has been eaten and I have had this anubhava, this the cow knows. I liked it then. So anubhutiya jatiyatvam is there. It can identify that jati. Thereby vyavaharanti. There is a typo here. Vyavaharanti ityartha. Anubhuta trunavad iti anumaya vyavaharanti. There is also anumana possible. This kind of anumana is possible. And thereby, pashus also have this vyavahara which is common. Then, adhuna heto pakshadharmata maha evamiti. Similarly, vivekina api we will look at in the next part. Yamiha karunikam sharanangato pyari sahodara apamahatpadam tamahamashu harim paramashri janakajankavananta sukhakritim. Om Tat Sat. Namaste.
Namaste. Dhanyavaad.